SpaceX caught the attention of the world over the weekend, making a first historic catch midair for one of its boosters. For more on what this leap means for space exploration, Bloomberg's Loren Grush joins us and was on shift over the weekend, covers SpaceX for us. Actually, there were two milestones, and we need to talk about the kind of Starship component of it. But let's start with the booster, why that was significant, and the idea of rapid reusability. Loren.
Right. Yeah, this was a big hurdle that SpaceX needed to clear in the road of development for Starship. As you mentioned, Starship's promise is that it's going to be fully reusable. So both portions of the vehicle need to survive after launch. But with the booster, you know, when they first proposed this idea, I think a lot of people were skeptical. Obviously, SpaceX has perfected landing its rockets with its Falcon 9. But when this was proposed, catching the rocket in midair rather than landing it, I think a lot of people were wondering how this would work. But it seemed to work just like a charm, at least from what we saw. And so I think they proved a lot of skeptics wrong over the weekend.
And now NASA going as far to consider that maybe we'll be landing on the moon, maybe using, of course, Starship as early as 2025. Talk us through what needs to happen to get there, Loren.
Yeah, I think the current plan is landing in 2026 with people. But, you know, just to caution, there's still quite a long road ahead for Starship. Obviously, this was a huge milestone for the company, but next they really need to showcase that they can refuel Starship in orbit. And so that's essentially like filling up at the gas tank, but with a lot more engineering challenges. Right. But this will be crucial to that because they have to catch and then relaunch the booster over and over again with back-to-back launches in order to perform those refueling missions.
So the other part, Starship gets up to orbital altitude, orbital speeds, goes around the world and control lands into the Indian Ocean. Talk me through that part, please.
Yeah, so during the last flight, you know, Starship struggled when it came back from space. We could see it kind of burning up and breaking apart when it was plunging through the atmosphere. But SpaceX said that they did a total revamp on the heat shield on Starship. And from what we saw, it seemed to survive relatively intact. I think we saw a little burn through, but definitely not nearly as significant as the prior flight. And then it did survive. And then when they tried to splash down in the ocean, they were able to flip and kind of do a pretty precise landing. So yeah, it really was a big milestone for both the booster and Starship, showcasing that maybe this rocket can be fully reusable, which is, to be fair, something that SpaceX hasn't been able to achieve yet with its Falcon 9. You know, part of the Falcon 9 still goes unused or is destroyed after launch. And so this would be a huge paradigm shift for SpaceX and for the launch industry in general.